Hey everybody! In this tutorial we will see how to connect Wildfly to PostgreSQL. All the information of this video are available on my blog at this address that you can find in the description too. I assume that you already have installed an instance of PostgreSQL and Wildfly or JBoss. In my case, I installed Postgres using Docker with the following instruction. The password on their user will be used to configure Wildfly. This is the installation through Docker with one command line, and as you can see, Wildfly is working correctly. I use the standalone version of Wildfly for all this demo. The next step is to download the JDBC driver from the PostgreSQL website. For our example, we will use the latest version. Now we can add a new module in Wildfly. In the folder modules, we add the following path: org PostgreSQL main. And we copy inside this new folder the driver that we just downloaded. Here we do a make dir for macOS and we move the file to the target destination. We quickly verify that everything is okay. Now we can assign the driver to a new module in Wildfly. To do this, we have to create a module.xml file in the folder that we just created and contains the driver. We add the resources to the file, that is basically the driver, name, and the mandatory dependencies. As alternative, Wildfly and JBoss offer us the possibility to install the module through the CLI. At this point, we have to add the new module containing the data source to the configuration. Find the config file of the instance you will be using. In our case, we are using standalone.xml. When you open the file, you have to locate where the data sources are defined. Now I found the data sources. In the config file, as you can see, there is already a memory database pre-existing in the instance of JBoss and Wildfly. We write our own data source, GNDI name. You can choose the name, but using the standard convention for the GNDI name, so Java column boss, JBoss, and we define the pool of connection name. Postgres DS in our case. We add the connection URL. This is the same of our Docker instance, so it's a localhost. In your case, you have to choose the location of your server. And now we can add the driver. We will define it in 1 minute. Now the name is PostgreSQL, still doesn't exist, at least in this file. And now we can define the username and password for the connection. This is the same that we used during the creation of the Docker instance of Postgres in our case. And finally, we can add the driver that previously we referenced in the data source. So it's the same name, PostgreSQL. We have to write the name of the module that we previously created in the folder and the class that is used to create the connection, which is org.postgresql.driver. Here is a snapshot of the code that we just wrote in the configuration. Now, last step is to test if everything is working correctly. We can start a new instance of standalone in our case. And to filter the log, we grab data sources. Here we see that the Postgres data source has been correctly initialized.